Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God. Thank God for everyone that's listening in with us. Amen. Glory to God. We are on the midnight prayer gathering, midnight morning glory prayer gathering on this morning. Glory to God. And we're going to go ahead and get started. Amen. I thank God for you. Amen. Thank you for joining us again on the midnight morning glory prayer gathering line on this morning. This is Apostle Robin Stokes and Reverend Joe Azamore. We're going to go to the throne room of prayer with you on this morning. We're going to go to our prayer line. Amen. And we're going to get prayer requests. And then we're going to hear a rhema word. Amen. About exposing the spirit of Jezebel. Exposing the spirit of jealousy. Amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. That's going to be another teaching, amen, exposing that Jezebel spirit, amen. But tonight, on this morning, we're going to talk about exposing that jealousy spirit. And this is going to be part three, amen. God bless you, God bless you. And we thank God again for you, amen, for joining us on the midnight morning glory gathering. And those that are looking to call in for a prayer request, please call in. That number is 857-232-0157. And the code is 716-052. Again, that's 857-232-0157. And the code is 716-052. And again, this is Reverend Joe Azamore and Apostle Robin Stokes with you on the midnight morning glory prayer gathering on this morning. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We thank God for you. Hallelujah. And those that may want to email us your prayer requests, please email us at the midnight morning glory prayer gathering. Amen. Again, that is midnight morning glory at gmail.com. Amen. Midnight morning glory at gmail.com. Midnight morning glory at gmail.com. Or you can call our midnight morning glory 24-hour line that we actually get on that line. We retrieve all the prayer requests from that line, and it is a live number. Amen. So you can always call us at 210-876-6475. Again, that number is 210-876-6475. And again, we thank God for you. Amen. I'm going to go ahead to the prayer line and see if there's anyone on the line that has a prayer request on this morning. Hello, God bless you. Do you have a prayer request on this morning? Amen, amen. I see we have a couple people on the line. If you have a prayer request, this is a time that you can go ahead and give us your prayer request. You don't have to give us your name. God knows who you are, amen. But if you have a prayer request, you can go ahead and give us that prayer request. We are on live, amen. So those that are listening to us live, you can call in. Amen. And that number again is 857-232-0157. The code is 716-052. Again, I have everybody off of mute here. Is there anyone that have a prayer request on this morning? Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Well, thank God for you. I know you're on the line to just touch and agree with us on this morning. Amen. And that's fine. We welcome you to the Midnight Morning Glory prayer gathering line on this morning. We thank God for those intercessors, those watchmen, those prayer warriors that have called in that are touching and agreeing with us on this morning. We definitely want to continue to lift up Brother Paul. Amen. Continue to pray for a miracle in his life. Amen. We want to continue and lift up our very own prophetess, amen, Renee, amen, God bless you, amen, continue to lift up her and her family, continue to lift up Brother Leroy, amen. Amen. Continue. And also Sister Runa, she called in on the midnight prayer line. Amen. So we want to continue to lift her up. We also want to continue to lift up those that may have lost a loved one. Amen. Those that are grieving and just missing their loved ones. We want to continue. And we want to ask God to definitely touch them right now and release His joy upon them and peace. And also to take care of any funeral arrangements that need to be taken care of, that they will be buried and that everything will be okay. Amen. I want to continue to pray for our youth, our children. Amen. While they're out of school. Amen. For their safety, and that God continue to cover them in His blood and of Jesus. And we want to continue to pray for our leaders. Amen. We'll continue to pray for the fivefold ministry. We continue to lift up our pastors to strengthen them as God have guided them to lead His sheep. Amen. To encourage their hearts to give them all the resources needed for the kingdom of God. Amen. So that they will be a help to the body of Christ. Amen. In a time or crisis. Amen. Want to continue to lift up our marriages. Amen. Want to continue to lift up those that God have called into the ministry, those that are newer in the ministry. Continue to lift them up, encourage them, encourage their hearts. Amen. To continue to keep them covered. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. I'm excited on this morning. I am going to move out the way, and I'm going to allow Reverend Joe Azamore to take over, and I'm going to come back and give the Rhema word on this morning, exposing the spirit of jealousy. Amen. We're going to be talking about David and Saul. Amen. As Reverend Joe Azamore, he taught on last week. It was an awesome teaching. Amen. You can always go back to Speaker. Amen. Or type in Midnight Morning Glory. Or speak on Speaker. And you can always go back and listen to the recordings. Amen. All the way back from last year, different recordings and prayers and everything. So if you want that link, you can always give us a call or email us, amen, at Midnight Morning Glory, and we will forward you that link, either text it to you or email it to you. Again, that's midnightmorningglory@gmail.com, amen. Or you can text us or leave us your callback number at 210-876-6475 along with your prayer request. Amen. Glory to God. But I thank God for you on this morning. And I thank God for the foundational scriptures that He have allowed us to stand on. Amen. The main scripture is Acts 16:25-26. And it says, "And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God, and the prisoners heard them. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prisons were shaking, and immediately all the doors were open, and everyone's bands were loosed." We are in the midnight hour on this morning. It is early morning. Amen. This is the time we command our morning. Amen. This is the time of spiritual warfare between 12 and 3. We know this is the third watch. We know this is the time that Satan tried to hijack the dreams and visions of the people of God as they begin to sleep. Amen. But as God continued to call His prayer warriors and intercessors and watchmen on the wall and not coming down until this watch is over, and as the other intercessors go into our fourth watch, amen, but we are called to the third watch, amen, and I believe that God is going to do a suddenly on this morning, because we're praying, we're singing praises unto God, and also not only that, the God is hearing us, amen, and not only that, God is ready to do a subtly, a great earthquake in our life. Amen. And every door, every prison door in our mind, every prison doors in our finances, every prison doors in our family, our marriages, they're going to come open, swing open wide, and all that negative stuff is going to be loosed in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So I'm excited on what God is going to do on this morning. He is always showing up. He's always showing up because He knows the heart of His people that praise. Amen. He know that we're touching and agreeing. We're believing and knowing that He's going to do what He said He's going to do. Because why? We have humbled ourselves. We have prayed. We have seeked His face. We have turned from our wicked ways. We come into repentance daily, true repentance, not outwardly, but inwardly, crying out, Abba, Father, asking Him to cleanse us, asking Him to change us, asking Him to turn things around in our life and repenting. Because He said we should come with a repentance heart. Amen. As we humble ourselves. And not only that, we turning from our wicked ways, amen. We're saying that it's not our will, but it is His will needs to be done in our life, amen. And now we know that He's going to hear us from heaven. He's going to forgive our sins, amen. And He's going to heal our land, not just our physical land, amen. But He's going to heal our spiritual land, our emotional land, our relational land, our social land, our financial land, our economic land, our government land. I know everything that's going on with the government and all the things that have happened over the week, but see, God is telling us all we have to do as men and women of God is humble ourselves and pray and seek His face and turn from our wicked ways, because He is ready to heal the land. He know that this is the land of the living, amen. But at the same time, when we begin to obey and walk in obedience and do what He's telling us to do, we don't have to rise up all of a sudden when something happened, amen. We should have been praying. We should have been going before the throne of a room of prayer, praying, being able to see things before they happen, amen. So therefore, as we take a stand and whatever it is that we know that it is not God, that God have already heard our prayer, so we must continue to pray daily. This is not something that we pick and choose, but we must pray daily. We must pray when we wake up, before we lay down, during our day, glory to God. We must seek His face. How do we seek His face? We seek His face through the word of God. We seek His face by just getting into that secret place, just being in that place of consecration, being in that place where we're prostrated, just listening to Him, not coming, asking for anything, but just coming, just because of who He is, glory to God. When we begin to follow the instructions that He have given us in 2 Chronicles 7:14, then He will begin to heal the land. He will begin to heal our government land. He will be able to go across the aisles, Democrat, Republican, the House, whatever, representatives, that He will be able to touch the hearts of those men and women, touch the hearts of those that's in the land. He will begin to heal the land. He will begin to do miracle signs and wonders. When we get into position, when we get into that place of prostration and consecrating ourselves and praying and seeking His face and turning from our wicked ways, because guess what? We can't change the heart of man, and we can't change the heart of nobody. Only God can. So we have to follow instructions, and when we follow instructions, He's going to do what He said He's going to do. He wants us to pull on Him. How do we pull on Him? With the most powerful tool that we have, and that is against Satan. That is prayer. Prayer in the spirit always, because the spirit knows what to intercede for us. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, He's calling us to that place of prayer. I'm not saying praying for 15 minutes and getting up. No, you got to lay there until you know that He have heard you, glory to God. Because see, when you pull on God, things begin to move even before you get out of that place of prostrating, glory to God. Things begin to happen. You begin to see the hand of God. You begin to hear Him. You begin to hear the instructions to go where and when and why and what and what. I'm telling you, you have to get into that place of prayer, glory to God. We can't teach you how to pray, glory to God. That's why He say pray in the spirit, because the spirit intercedes for you, glory to God. Hallelujah. It's not how eloquent we pray or how long we pray, but it's in getting into that secret place, that place where you meet God at, amen. You just can't come into that place any kind of way. You have to be able to get into that inner place, glory to God. You got to come from the outer to get to the inner, glory to God. So you got to begin to give God praise. You got to begin to worship Him. You got to begin to just admire Him and just awe Him, glory to God, in order to get into that inner place, glory to God. Because remember, Paul and Silas, they were thrown in the inner prison, amen. That inner prison, what they didn't know in the spiritual realm was that inner place. That was that place where they were able to lay prostrate before Him. And all they knew to do was to pray. All they knew to do was to sing praise to Him, and the prisoners heard Him. And I believe that because there was such a great earthquake, they began to join in, glory to God, because it says that when 2 and 3 gather in His name, glory to God, He began to move, glory to God. We know that one can chase 10,000, glory to God. So just imagine all the prisoners that was
in that prison. They began to chase thousands, glory to God. Thousands. And then there was a great earthquake, glory to God. Chains begin to break. Chains begin to break loose. Chains begin to fall. Prison doors begin to open. They were free, glory to God. And we know the story. The jailer didn't know what to do because he knew back then that if any prisoner was released without them being released legally in their system, that the jailer would be held responsible. So he knew that it was a move of God because he began to drop to his knees and say, what must I do to be saved? He knew that it was nothing natural, but he knew it was something spiritual. He began to think about his whole household because his whole household got saved that night. Glory to God. I'm telling you on this morning, God is about to loose some chains. He's about to break some things in your life. He's about to open some prisons in your mind. He's about to open some doors of opportunity for you. I'm not here just to prophesy to you, but I'm here to pray with you because it's through prayer where you're going to meet God. You got to know how to pray and touch God on your own, glory to God. Hallelujah. So I'm going to go ahead and ask Reverend Joe Azamore. He's on the line with us, glory to God, to go ahead and begin whatever God lead him to do. And then we're going to come back and we're going to hear what the Lord had for us, amen, about exposing that spirit of jealousy, amen. Because if you harboring that spirit of jealousy in you, you ain't going to be able to move nothing, glory to God, because that spirit entangles itself with so many other spirits, and so now you out of the will of God. It's time for us to get back in the will of God. It's in time for us to move out the way and die out to ourselves. Hallelujah. Glory to God, Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Reverend Joe Azamore, or you on the line with us. Glory to God.
Amen. 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 Wherever that you are, I want you to begin to thank God, begin to bless the name of the living God, for He alone is worthy. He alone is worthy. Begin to bless the name of the living God. Begin to bless the name of the living God, for He alone is worthy. He alone is worthy. Father, we give you praise, we give you the honor, we give you the glory, we give you the adoration. Your name be magnified, your name be exalted, your name be lifted high. There is none like thee, and none can be compared unto your God. We bless your name, 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 we bless your name. Father, we give you praise, we give you the honor, we give you the glory, we give you the adoration. Your name be magnified, your name be exalted, your name be lifted high. There is none like thee, and none can be compared unto your God. We thank you, Lord Jesus. 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 We thank you for the gift of life. We thank you for your revelations, O God. We thank you for your favor. We thank you for your mercies. We thank you for all that you're doing in our lives, O God. We thank you, 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 God. We thank you, God. We just want to thank you for all that you're doing and all that you're about to do in our lives, O God. We give you all the praise, we give you all the honor, we give you all the glory. Your name be magnified, your name be exalted, your name be lifted high. There is none like thee, and none can be compared unto your God. We give you all the praise, 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 we give you all the praise. We give you all the praise, 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 we give you all the praise. We bless your name, we bless your name, we bless your name, we bless your name, we bless your name. We bless your name, 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 we bless your name. Father, Lord, we give you the praise, we give you the honor, we give you the glory. Mi graska pan tore mana mana mazwe mama mama. Shambele bele 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 zimbaya bala bala bale. Kamo zi graska pan tore bele 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 zwe mama mama mama. Shambele bele 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 zwe mama mama. Shambele bele bele bele. Ikan thaya mana mana mama zwe mama mama. Man tore bele 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 zwe mama. Ibrian tore bele bele. Shambele bele 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 zwe mama mama. Imbole bele bele bele. Le graska pan tore bele 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 zwe mama mama mama. Shambele bele 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 zwe mama mama. Ibrian tore bele bele. Zwe mama mama, we bless you, Lord, bless you, Lord, bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord. You're worthy to be praised and adored. Your name be magnified. Your name be exalted. Your name be lifted high. There is none like thee. 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 There is none like thee, O God. We bless your holy name. We magnify your holy name. We exalt your holy name. We lift your name on high, O God. 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 Magras ka pat tole bele bele zwe ma ma ma. Shambele bele 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 zibrian tole ma 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 zwe ma ma ma. Man tole ma 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 zimbo le bele 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 shaka tay bala 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 zwe ma 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 ma. Ika bala 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 zwe ma bala 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 le kabozi kabaza kabose ke tere ma. Father Lord, we give you praise. We give you honor. We give you glory. We give you glory. We give you glory. We bless your name, we bless your name, we bless your name, we bless your name, we bless your name. Blessed be thy name, and you are worthy to be praised and adored. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen. We are also praying once again. We are committing ourselves into the hands of God. We are praying that God should strengthen us in the Christian faith. God should equip us in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us begin to pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray that, Lord, you will equip us. We pray that, Lord, you will strengthen us. We pray that, Lord, you will grant us according to our heart desire, O God. We pray that, Lord, you will strengthen us and quicken our immortal bodies. In the mighty name of Jesus, Paul said that you can do all things through Christ that strengthens us. We pray that, Lord, you strengthen us in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray for your strength, O God. We pray that, Lord, you may quicken our immortal bodies in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray that, Lord, strengthen us in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we pray for your strength. We cannot do without you. We cannot do without you. Come strengthen us. Come strengthen us. Come quicken our immortal bodies. In the mighty name of Jesus. Mambo ziki taya mama sindori manama zwe mama. Ye kabaya tole bele bele zwe mama. Ye kabaya bala 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 zwe mama. Man tole bele 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 zwe mama. Shika taya bala 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 zwe mama. Ye kabaya tole bele 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 zwe mama. Ye kabaya bala 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 zwe mama. Shika taya mana 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 zwe mama. Ye kaba sik tole bele bele zwe mama. Ye kabro zi kaba sak taya mana mana zumba bala. Sham bele 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 zwe mama. Father Lord, we pray and we call on you to come and strengthen us, O God. Come and strengthen us, O God. Come strengthen us, O God, in our Christian faith, O God. Come strengthen us, O God. Father, we pray for your strength. Na kaburo sindara bala bala zwe mama. Ye kama tole bele bele zwe mama. Ye kabaya bala 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 zo mama shimbele bele 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 ziba bala bala le kaboski banta bala 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 zo mama. Father Lord, come and strengthen us in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says that the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they are mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds of the enemy. We are praying, we are coming against every weapon and every plan of the enemy against God's people across the world in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us begin to pray in the mighty name of Jesus. We are praying for pastors, we are praying for apostles, we are praying for ministers of God, that every spirit, every power, and every authority that fight against them, we are coming against in the mighty name of Jesus. We are praying that God should equip them in the mighty name of Jesus to stand in these end times for his kingdom in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us begin to pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray, we commit your people into your hands, O God. We pray that, Lord, you will strengthen and continue to equip them in the mighty name of Jesus. Equip them for this end times in the mighty name of Jesus. Give them the strength and the ability to stand on your behalf in the mighty name of Jesus. Every spirit and every power and every authority that fights against your people, we come against in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against every spirit. We come against every power, we come against every authority, we come against every spirit in the mighty name of Jesus. We pull down every stronghold of the enemy in the mighty name of Jesus. We pull down every stronghold of the enemy against men and women of God in the mighty name of Jesus. We break in the mighty name of Jesus every stronghold in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against every stronghold in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against every stronghold in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray in the mighty name of Jesus, and we come against every stronghold of the enemy. We come against every stronghold of the enemy In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray and we come against every stronghold of the enemy. We come against every stronghold of the enemy. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray and we come against every stronghold. We pull down every stronghold of the enemy. Every demonic attack against your people, we come against in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against every power. We come against every spirit that has been assigned to manipulate against children of God. In the mighty name of Jesus, wherever they are, whether they are in the air, the sea, under the sea, we command them to lose. And they are to lose their hopes in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against satanic manipulations. We come against satanic orchestrations. In the mighty name of Jesus, we break and we destroy. We pull down every stronghold of the enemy in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against powers. We come against principalities. We come against transcendental meditators. We come against astral projectors. We come against familiar spirits. We come against every spirit that is not of God. I will try to fight against children of God and men of God across the world in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against every spirit. We come against every authority. We come against every power in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against every power in the mighty name of Jesus. Magraska panto ke bosi ke televizwe mama. Ikare antole belevezwe malaba shambele belevezibri antole belevezwe mama. Man tore bala bala ba zwe ma ba shabele bele bele zigri an tore mana mana ye ka be ya bala ba zwe ma la bala ba zigras ka pa ka bro tore bala man tore bele 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 zwe ma 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 ni ka ta ya bala bala ba zwe bo re ba shabri an tore bele 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 zwe ma 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 yi ka bri an tore bele 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 zwe ma 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 man tore ba ya bala bala ma zwe ma 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 yi ka bro zi ka ba 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 zi bo re bele bele zi ka bri an tore bele 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 zwe ma 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 Shambele bele 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 zwe ma 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 man tole bele 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 zwe ma 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 shambele bele 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 zwe ma 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 graska pan tole bele 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 zwe ma 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 shambele bele 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 zimbra thala bala 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 zwe ma ba 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 shambele bele imbala bala 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 kabu shiki tele bala bala zwe ma ma shambele bele bele zwe ma 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 ikaba bala 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 zwe ma 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 we come against every spirit and every celestial being that has been assigned to manipulate against your people in the mighty name of Jesus. For they shall surely gather together against thee, but not by my name. Whosoever shall gather against thee shall fall for thy name's sake. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Every gathering of the enemy, every demonic gathering, every satanic gathering concerning ministers of God, we come against in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against every gathering of the enemy in the mighty name of Jesus. And we pull down every stronghold of the enemy in the mighty name of Jesus. Even as we pray, let us continue to intercede for people that are sick. We are praying that everybody that is sick, every person that is sick, that comes on this prayer line to pray with us, everybody that is sick emotionally, physically, psychologically, we are praying for the power and the anointing of God to be released into their life and minister unto them healing and salvation and deliverance in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we pray in the mighty name of Jesus. We intercede for your people, O God, that every sickness that is fighting your people, we come against in the mighty name of Jesus. We rebuke every sickness in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says that at the mention of the name Jesus, every knee should bow and every tongue should confess that our Lord Jesus Christ is Lord. Even as we mention the name of our Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we command every sickness to bow in the mighty name of Jesus and come out of every individual that is on the line that is not feeling well. In the mighty name of Jesus, we come against every sickness in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against every sickness that manifests emotionally in the mighty name of Jesus. Every sickness that manifests psychologically, every sickness that manifests spiritually, every sickness that manifests in our mind, in our body, in our spirit, and in our soul, we come against in the mighty name of Jesus. Every sickness that manifests in our blood, we come against in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against every sickness in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, you are the Lord that healed thee. We pray that, Lord, you minister healing unto your people in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against every sickness. We rebuke every sickness. We curse every sickness. We command every sickness to leave God's people in the mighty name of Jesus. We command every sickness to leave God's people in the mighty name of Jesus. And we command every sickness never to come back again in the mighty name of Jesus. We command sickness never to come back again in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against every sickness. We rebuke every sickness in the mighty name of Jesus. We rebuke every sickness in the mighty name of Jesus. We rebuke every sickness in the mighty name of Jesus. We rebuke every sickness in the mighty name of Jesus. We come, Zigraska, Pantoreva, Zibrian, Toreva, Zuema, Mama. Shambelebelebe Zubrian Tamana Mama, Le Cabrozi Cabasa Cabian Torebelebe Zuema Mama, Shambelebelebe Zuema Mama, Le Cabroski Bantabalabalaba Zuema Mama, Shambelebelebe Zuema Mama, Y Cabrian Torebelebe Zimbalabalaba Shabelebe, Le Cabalabalaba Zuema Mama. We come against every sickness in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against every sickness in the mighty name of Jesus. My bros keep on tie up alaba zue ma mama. Jesus name. Let kabo si kabi an tole balaba zue ma ma mama. Nyan tole ma mama mama zue ma ma mama. Sham bere 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 zue ma balaba balaba zibri an tole ma mama mama. Yi kabro zi ka pas ka pi an tole ma mama mama zue ma 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 mama. Sham bere 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 zue ma ma mama. Yi kabro zi ka pas ka pan tole ma mama mama zue ma 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 mama. Shambelebelebelebelebe zue ma 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 ma. Maska pantole ma 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 zue ma 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 ma. Shambelebelebelebelebe zue ma 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 ma. Weka ma 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 ma. Yi kabron tole belebelebelebe zue ma 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 ma. Shambelebelebelebelebelebe zue ma 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 ma. Kaba ba la ba la ba zue ba la ba la ba la ba. Shambele bele 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 ziba ba la ba la ba. Le kaba lo 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 zumba ba la ba la. Re kaba ska pan tole bele 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 zue ma 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 ma. Shambele bele 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 zimba ba la ba la ba. E kama ma ma ma. Man tole mana 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 zue ma 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 ma. E kabrian tole bele 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 zue ma ba ba ba. Shambele bele 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 zamba la ba la ba la. Man tole bala 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 zue ma 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 ma. Man tele bele 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 zibriyan tole bala bala bala. Sham bele 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 zibriyan ta ma na ma na ma. Yika taya bala 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 zibriyan tele bele 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 zimba ya bala bala bala. Le ka mo si ka ska pan tole bele 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 zimba ba 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 ba. Sham bele 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 zue ma 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 ma. My grass ka pan tole ma na ma na ma zue ma 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 ma. Yika briyan tole bele 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 zue ma 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 ma. Man tole bala 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 zue ma ya bala bala. Le kabros ki ban ta ma na ma na ma zue ma 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 ma. Yi kamos ki pin ta la bala 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 zue ma 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 ma. Sham bele 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 zue ma 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 ma. Yi kabros ki ban ta ma na ma na ma. Every spirit, every power that is fighting against people of God according to their health, I come against in the mighty name of Jesus. Ma gras ka pan tori bala bala zue ma ma ma. Spirit of God in the mighty name of Jesus. Every power and every spirit that is fighting against the health of your children, I come against in the mighty name of Jesus. I rebuke every sickness in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. We are still praying. We are coming against every spirit that is fighting against our lives, even as we intercede on the line for people of God, even as we intercede for our brothers, even as we intercede for our sisters. We are also praying that God should intervene in our lives. God should restore unto us the favor, and the grace of God should be greater upon our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us continue to pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray, we come against every spirit and every power that fights against us, even as we intercede for your people, O God. Every spirit that will try to fight against us, every spirit that will try to manipulate against us, we come against in the mighty name of Jesus. And we pray for your favor, we pray for your favor and your mercy, O God, to abound upon our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your favor, let your glory, let your favor, let your favor, let your favor and your glory abound upon our lives in the mighty name of Jesus, even as we continue to pray. We pray for your favor, we pray for your mercies, we pray for your favor, we pray for your mercies, we pray for your favor and your mercies, O God. Jesus, your favor and your mercies, your favor and your mercies, your favor and your mercies. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray for your favor, we pray for your mercies. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray that, Lord, you will grant us according to our heart desire. In the mighty name of Jesus, even as we intercede for your people, O God. We pray that, Lord, you will come and strengthen us, O God. We pray that, Lord, you will come and quicken us, O God. We pray that, Lord, You will come and reveal yourself unto us, O God, even as we intercede for your people, even as we intercede for your kingdom, O God. We pray for your power and your anointing to manifest also in our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. Man tole vele 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 zimbala vele vele shambele vele 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 zema mama mama yikabian tole vele 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 zwe mama mama shambele vele 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 zwe mama mama yikata vele 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 zwe mama mama shambele vele 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 zwe mama mama yikata vele 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 zwe mama mama shambele vele 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 zwe mama mama man tole vele 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 zwe mama mama Magraska pantole vele 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 zue mama mama shambele vele 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 zue brian tole vele vele ikaba zikaba ikabroski banta mama mama zue mama mama shambele vele 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 zue brian tala vele vele kabule vele vele zue mama mama Man tole baya bala ba zibro zika paska pan tole vele vele shambele vele 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 zimbaya bala bala ba re kabule vele vele zibrian tama mama mama Man tala bala 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 zimbo le bele bele shambele bele bele reka maska pan tole bele bele zwe mama mama shambele bele bele ikaba 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 Man tole bala bala zwe mama mama imbo le bele bele reka maska pan tole bele bele zwe mama mama shambele bele 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 zwe mama bala 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 zwe mama mama Man tole bala 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 zwe mama mama ikata bala 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 zumba ya bele bele sha bele 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 zumba ya bala bala ma grass ka pan tole bele 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 zwe mama mama Jesus name ma grass ka pa ka bozi ka pa ta bala bala zwe mama man tole bele 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 shibiri an tala bala ma ka ya tole bele 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 zwe mama mama Shambele bele 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 zwe ma ba 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 e kabrian tole bele 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 zwe ma ba 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 shambele bele 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 zibrian tala bala bala man tole bele bele we come against every spirit we come against every power le kaboski pan tala bala bala zimbole bele bele shambele bele bele ma graska pan tala bala 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 zwe ma 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 shamba da ba da ba da ba e kaba da ba 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 man tole bala 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 zwe ma 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 Shambele bele 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 zibrian ta bala 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 zwe mama mama shambele bele 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 zwe mama mama man tole bele 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 zwe ma ba 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 ikha ta bala 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 zwe mama mama shambele bele 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 le kha ba bala bala ma tole ba bala bala zo gras ka pan tole bele 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 zwe ba da blose ke tele bele bele zwe ba da bala ze kabrian tole bele 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 Man de levo so kinda bala 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 zwe mama mama shambele bele 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 zwe mama mama in the mighty name of Jesus Father we pray in the mighty name of Jesus le kabaza kabozi kabian tole bele bele zwe mama mama man tole bala 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 zwe mama 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 shambele bele 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 zwe mama 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 man tole bele 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 zwe mama mama man tole bele 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 zwe mama mama Ma graska pan tole bele 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 zwe mama mama shambele bele 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 zwe mama mama ma graska pan tole bele 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 zwe ma baba e bala bala ba zima la bala ba man tole bele 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 zwe ma bada 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 ba man tole bala 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 zwe ma mama man tole bele 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 zima la bala bala ba shambele bele bele man tole bele 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 zibrian tole bala 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 zwe ma mama mama man tole bala 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 zwe ma mama mama It cut Tayabala Balaba Zimbole, Shambele, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. At this point, we would like to hand over to Apostle Robin. But if any of you on the line have a prayer request or you want something that you wanted to pray about, you can come out so you can dial so that we can pray with you. Wherever that you are, you can call us on the prayer line and we can pray with you. Or you can call this number so that we pray with you. You can call 857-232-0157. And the code is 716052. Again, 857-232-0157. And the code is 716052. You can also email us at midnightmorningglory@gmail.com or you can also call 210 210-876-6475. You can call us and leave your prayer request. Anything that you want us to pray about, just call in and let us know. Or we will pray with you on the line. Or you can send us an email so that we will pray with you the next time on the line. Amen.
Glory to God, glory to God. Is there anyone on the line? We're off mute. Do you have a prayer request? Amen. You can go ahead with your prayer request. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Well, we're going to go ahead and continue. Again, we thank you. We see that you're on the prayer line, but if you want to hold off on your prayer request, that's fine. That's why we're on the line to pray with you. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We're going to go ahead, and I just got a couple scriptures that I'm going to read with you on this morning, and then we're going to close it out in prayer. Amen. Glory to God. We're here just to do what God has assigned us to do and nothing more. Amen. So let's go ahead and begin as the Lord gave me the scripture that we're going to be reading from on this morning, 1 Samuel, starting with verse 18. Amen. And we're going to be talking about here David and Jonathan's friendship. Amen. And then we're going to go into Saul's jealousy of David. Amen. In 1 Samuel 18 and 6. But let's go ahead and begin with 1 Samuel 18 and 1. And it came to pass when he had made an end speaking unto Saul, that the soul of Jonathan was knit with the soul of David, and Jonathan loved him as his own soul. And verse 2. And Saul took him that day and would let him go no more home to his father. Then Jonathan and David made a covenant, because he loved him as his own soul. And Jonathan stripped himself of the robe that was upon him, and gave it to David, and his garments, even to his sword, and his bow, and his girdle. And David went out whithersoever Saul sent him, and behaved himself wisely. Did you hear what the word of God said? 1 Samuel 18 and 5. And David went out whithersoever Saul sent him, and behaved himself wisely. And Saul set him over the men of war, and he was accepted in the sight of all men, and also in the sight of Saul's servant. 1 Samuel 18 and 6. And it came to pass as they came, when David was returned from the slaughter of the Philistine, that the woman came out of the city of Israel singing and dancing to meet King Saul with tabrets with joy, with instruments of music. And the women answered one another as they played and said, Saul hath slain his thousands and David his 10,000. And Saul was very wroth, and saying displeased him. And he said, they have ascribed unto David 10,000, and to me they have ascribed but thousands. And what can he have more but the kingdom? Oh, Lord, what can he have more but the kingdom? And Saul eyed David from that day and forward. And it came to pass on the morrow that the evil spirit from God came upon Saul, and he prophesied in the midst of the house. And David played with his hand, as at other times there was a javelin in Saul's hand. And Saul cast the javelin, for he said, I will smite David even to the wall with it. And David avoided out of his presence twice. And Saul was afraid of David, because the Lord was with him, and was disparted from Saul. Therefore Saul removed him from him, and made him his captain over 1,000. And he went out and came in before the people. And David behaved himself wisely in all his ways, and the Lord was with him. Wherefore when Saul saw that he behaved himself very wisely, he was afraid of him. But all Israel and Judah loved David, because he went out and came in before him. Glory to God. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this word. You've already spoken in this word. You've already given us, oh God, the revelation of this word already through your scripture. And God, I thank you, oh God, for decreasing me, oh God, that you will reveal through me, oh God, exposing that spirit of jealousy on this morning through your word, oh God. And God, we thank you right now that someone, oh God, will be saved and set free, oh God, from that spirit of jealousy on this morning, oh God, that they will be able to go forth, oh God, in the things that you have called them to in the mighty name of Jesus. And in the name of Jesus, we give you the glory, we give you the honor in Jesus' name. Amen. Glory to God. It says, for those that may have just joined us, we're reading from 1 Samuel verse 18 through 16. And also, I just want to give a reference scripture for those also that's Bible scholars, those that have their Bible with them right now. You can also mark James 1, 14 and 15. It says, but every man is tempted when he is drawn away of his own lust and enticed. Then when lust have conceived, it bring forth sin. And sin, when it's finished, bring forth death. Glory to God. Amen. Glory to God. Again, we're exposing that spirit of jealousy on this morning. Glory to God. We know that that spirit of jealousy is not of God. Amen. And we know in this story that Saul had a spirit of jealousy. Amen. We don't know, he was anointed king, amen, at the time. So therefore, just because of the women saying, okay, he only slain thousands, but David slain 10,000, that was the beginning, amen. But I believe that he even had a little of jealousy in him when David killed Goliath, amen, because he was king and they went out to go to war, and David heard about this Philistine and this Goliath giant, amen, and he was just tending to his father's sheep, amen, and when he heard of this, he knew what God can do, because him being in the pastures tending to his father's sheep, amen, he saw how God allow him to not only just tend to the sheep, but God also allow him and taught him how to keep the sheep safe. Amen. How to keep them in green pastures and even how to keep them wise. Amen. Making sure that they don't stray away, because anytime they will stray away, any other animal can attack them and devour them. So David taught them how to stay within the green pastures, amen. And even when they tried to wander, he began to break their legs and to put them back on course, amen. It wasn't to hurt them, but it was just to keep them safe in the green pastures. That's like God is keeping us safe within the hedges of protection that he has us in, amen. So therefore, he's keeping us, he wants us to be in his will and not our will, because when we step out of those green pastures, when we step out of the will of God, then the enemy has access to do whatever he wants to do. Amen. But even during that time, David was taking care of his father's sheep. God began to train him, amen, not even knowing that one day that he would be king, amen, because they looked at him just like a shepherd boy. They looked at him like he was a nobody. He was rejected. He was displaced. Glory to God. And I even believe that he had some insecurity about himself, amen. But at the time when he was growing and being groomed, God began to groom him for him to walk in boldness, for him to be confident, because I believe his confidence increase, because when he began to tend to the sheep, God taught him how to keep them safe. That means that he taught him how to fight against those lions and bears and all those other animals that would try to devour the sheep. Glory to God. God showed him how to take a slingshot, glory to God, with a rock, glory to God, that represents Christ, glory to God, and how to aim it at that animal and be able to attack that animal without even using his hands, glory to God, because we know that David wasn't real big, amen. He was just a young boy, amen. And we know that we cannot, you know, when it comes to a lion and a bear, there's no way that we can even win, amen. But God, only God, glory to God, is able to do that thing, what he did for David. But at the same time, let's go back. You know, I just want to just give you a backdrop of David, because for him to even have this confidence to say, wow, now this Philistine, this
Goliath giant. Glory to God. I feel not only that I feel, but I feel the faith, because his faith was great. Amen. It wasn't the sling or the rock that killed Goliath. Amen. It was the faith behind it. Amen. He knew what God can do. He knew that God was the one that will be the one who fought his battles. He knew that it was God that had all power in his hand. He just walked in the confidence and boldness that God gave him. Amen. But even as he was back in the sheepfold, glory to God, tending to the sheep, he heard about this Philistine, this Goliath, glory to God. So I believe that God had him in training camp, like God has us. He has us in training camp. God would never send us to the war unprepared. Amen. That's just like spiritual warfare. He would never send us out there alone. Amen. That's when we call on our warring angels, amen, to fight on our behalf, amen, our ministering angels to minister to us, our guardian angels to guard us, glory to God. So I believe as God trained him and got him prepared, amen, he was ready to fight the battle, but he didn't know that God was preparing him to become king. But that's what God would do. He would sit us in a place where we would feel like we're being rejected. We would feel like we're being displaced. We would feel like we're in Lodabar somewhere, amen. Come on, somebody. But God got us in that place because he's trying to equip us. He's trying to make our mouth as sharp as a sword. He's trying to polish our shaft. He's trying to hide us in that case, that quiver, to keep us hidden until that time comes. Because see, he don't want no man getting the glory. He wants the glory. And I believe he hid David, amen. And then when the anointing began to flow, glory to God, even though they didn't even call David forth, Samuel knew that it was someone else, glory to God. He said, no, there's another son that you have, because see, the oil is not flowing with these other six, glory to God. But there's another son, glory to God. And everybody looked like David, glory to God. I know they say that about you. Yeah, God would allow the anointing to flow on anybody, because we just read it in the scripture that Saul went and began to prophesy. Even though he was carrying that spirit of jealousy, he still was able to prophesy. Glory to God, because gifts comes without repentance, glory to God. But at the same time, when that oil began to flow and they poured it upon David, he was anointed king, glory to God. See, that was just one of the first steps of the anointing, glory to God. He was being prepared. So even when he went out, I believe that boost up his confidence even more, to say, you know what, I believe behind this rock God can kill this Philistine, this giant, glory to God. So he began to go forth, and when he went to war to fight that Philistine giant, glory to God, it happened, and he was defeated, glory to God. Then he was sent out to do more war, glory to God, and the women came back saying, David killing 10,000, amen. This made Saul very angry, amen. Not only did it make him angry, it made him wroth. It made him have some hatred in him. He began to feel insecurity. See, that's how this spirit of jealousy operates. It just don't be birthed into jealousy. It starts off being envy. It starts off being hatred. It starts off being insecure of somebody else or something that somebody else have, glory to God. Saul already had the kingdom. He already had the anointing, glory to God. But it was something that he was jealous about David about, amen, because he saw the glory of God upon him. He heard the worship in him when he began to play the harp, amen, because we know that God allowed God will provoke us into purpose, because he made a way for David to come in to play even worship music, the harp, because he sent evil spirits upon Saul. So he called on David to come in and to play for him. And as David began to play for him, those spirits began to be removed. Amen. God was already setting it up. He was already putting David in place. He was already bringing David into the kingdom. He was already bringing David into the palace, because he wanted David to see what it's like being king. He needed him to understand the different things about kingdomship, amen, about kingship, glory to God. So therefore, God would never put us in a place unprepared, amen. But even though that Saul felt this jealousy about David, I believe, had a spirit of discernment, because he knew that Saul felt this way, amen. But one of the things that I love about the scripture Even though Saul had the spirit of jealousy upon him, amen, David still respected the man of God. He still respected the king, amen. He began to continue to do his work, what? Wisely, amen, because he knew that scripture, touch my anointed, do my prophet no harm, glory to God. So therefore, he respected Saul's kingship. But Saul had this jealousy against David. This jealousy turned into wrath. It turned into anger. It turned into hate. It turned into insecurity. It turned him feeling like, okay, I'm about to be displaced out of the kingdom. Glory to God. It turned into even a murdering spirit. Glory to God. Because when he picked up the javelin, he was ready to kill David. Amen. See, all these spirits come out of jealousy, glory to God. So therefore, you got to know these spirits that is attached to the spirit of jealousy, glory to God. So God is letting us know in this scripture, he set it up to let us know how Saul became jealous of David, because they were saying he killed 10,000 when Saul only killed thousands. That right there raised up an antenna saying, how could they say that he killed 10,000, I've killed 1,000, and I'm a king. So automatically, he felt threatened about his kingship. He felt threatened about the kingdom. He felt threatened about the throne that he was sitting on, glory to God. But see, when you know you're walking in obedience, and you know you're walking in the things that God have called you to do, you won't feel threatened. But see, Saul knew that he had was disobedient, because when God told him, gave him directions, glory to God, through the prophet Samuel, when he told him what to do when he went to war, he didn't do that, amen. He brought them back to his kingdom. He brought the people. He brought the materialistic things back when God said, don't bring nothing back. So he walked in disobedience. So that right there took his kingship. That right there took the throne from him because of disobedience. See, disobedience, glory to God, takes us out of the will of God. Disobedience is a form of witchcraft, glory to God. So therefore, he was in disobedience, glory to God. But at the same time, this spirit of jealousy rose so far up in him that he began to hate David. But he still knew that David was wise, because in verse 18 and 14, it said, and David behaved himself wisely in all his ways, and the Lord was with him. When Saul saw that he behaved himself very wisely, he was afraid of him. In spite of all the things that Saul tried to do prior with the javelin, tried to hit him with the javelin, and then not only that, David still respected him as king. This spirit of jealousy will have you moving out of the will of God. This spirit of jealousy will have you walking in disobedience. This spirit of jealousy will have you walking in anger, will have you walking in hate, envy, and all those other spirits that attach itself to it. Amen. Because one of the things we must understand, people, they become jealous of you. Yes, people become jealous of you. And when people become jealous of you, they have actually come into agreement with the father of lies, Satan. Because they have now moved out of the will of God and begin to walk in the will of Satan. Because now they're allowing Satan to use them. Amen. See, the devil continually challenges us, amen, because he wants us to get out of the will of God, amen. He don't want us to reap the fruit, amen, that God has for us. He wants us to get out of the will of God so that we won't reap the promises and the blessings that God has already given to us, amen. So therefore, the enemy would try to plant this seed of jealousy. He would try to plant that seed of hate and anger, insecurity, displacement, rejection, and all those other spirits that attach itself to that spirit of jealousy. Then it begins to lie to you and say different things to you, like they don't like me, or they're not for me. And then you begin to believe these things. And now you're acting jealous for something that it ain't even true. Because we know Satan is the father of lies. So now he done put all this stuff in your mind, and now your mind is out of the will of God. So now you have allowed Satan to come into your mind and play tricks on your mind. Now you got this spirit of jealousy in you, and you don't even know why you're jealous. You don't even know why you don't like your brother and sister. You just don't like them. You don't like them because somebody else don't like them. That's not the will of God. God said that we should love one another. Amen. So therefore, we got to move away from allowing Satan to come into our minds and plant seeds in our mind to make us feel that somebody don't like us or somebody is doing this to us, when really in reality they don't even know us. Amen. But because that seed have been planted, that we feel like, okay, this and that. Amen. So therefore, Satan is a father of lies. You cannot allow him to put those lies into your mind. Amen. See, this spirit of jealousy, amen, it even attaches itself to the spirit of death and infirmity. This is a generational stronghold, amen, amen. See, the spirit of jealousy is always attacking you, amen. And the reason why this spirit always attacks you is because it makes you feel like you're a victim, amen. So it's really like a victim spirit, amen. It becomes a stronghold. And another stronghold that attaches itself to the spirit of jealousy is that Freemasonry spirit. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. That mental illness spirit. Amen. That financial curse spirit. That spirit of hate, bitterness, anger, murder. All those spirit envy. Because it began to start with envying. When you begin to envy somebody or something that they have. See, Saul began to envy David because why? First of all, he was handsome. He was young and he had faith. Amen. He killed Goliath, not on his own will, but because of God. Amen. Then he knew how to play the harp. He knew how to worship. Amen. And in his worship, it eliminated that evil spirit that always came onto Saul. Amen. He began to envy him. I even believe through the relationship between Jonathan, which is Saul's son, and David. When Jonathan even gave David his Saul, gave him his sword, glory to God, gave him his bow, gave him his robe. Amen. Because he saw the God in David. See, he was lifting David up. He was encouraging David. He knew that David was about to take the throne. He knew what it was like to walk in kingship. Why? Because his father was king. Amen. He knew what it was like to live in a palace. He done had all the things. He knew that he didn't have the anointing for kingship. He was willing to give up the things that he had in order for the man of God, which was David, to be able to have the sword, the bow, and the robe to be able to walk in his kingship. Amen. Amen. Are we willing to give up some things, amen, to allow our brother and sister to walk in that kingship, that priesthood that God has given to them, amen? See, that's when you know you're delivered from that spirit of jealousy, when you're able to lift up your brother and your sister, encourage them, give them things that will help them in their ministry, amen, not just financial support, but words of encouragement. Amen. If God tell you to do it, you better do it. Amen. Because God will deal with you. See, we don't want to be chastised by God, because we know that's a whooping that, oh my God, hallelujah. I know, because I done been chastised many times before. But at the same time, Jonathan knew that David was called to this kingship. Amen. And Saul was jealous of their relationship, amen. Glory to God. So he was envying David in the beginning. Then when the people began to say, hey, Saul, you only killed 1,000, and David killed 10,000, he ain't even king. So he thinking like, oh, he coming up in here, he about to take the throne. What else could he have? The kingdom? Wait a minute, something ain't right. I'm the king. And it's like in the church, somebody come in and God have called them automatically, the territorial spirit. Yeah, we're going to talk about the territorial spirit, because this is connected to the spirit of jealousy too. People begin to have that territorial spirit where they only going to let nobody in their territory. So therefore, they're going to speak lies about that anointed one to get them out of their space because they feel threatened. But see, when God sent a gift, amen. See, we got to be careful what we pray for, because when we pray, Lord, send me help. Lord, send somebody in here to help us in the ministry. Send somebody to do this, Lord. Then when he sent them, because you don't like what the outside look like, you automatically begin to judge them. That spirit of judgmental is also connected to the spirit of jealousy. Having a judgmental spirit. Because how could you judge what God done sent? You pray for help. You pray for the things that God has sent. But because you don't like the outside, because you allow that judgmental spirit to take over your spirit, you is rejecting what God has sent. So now that judgmental spirit is rising up. And that jealousy spirit is right there knocking at the door. So therefore, we got to be careful what we pray for. Amen. Because he called on David to come and play for him because he heard about his worship. He heard about his anointing. He knew that the glory of God rested on him. He called David into the palace. Glory to God. So therefore, he began to envy him. Then when they began to talk about, oh, he did this, David did that. Now he began to have wrath against David. Wrath turns into anger. Wrath turns into hatred. Wrath turns into bitterness. Wrath turns into murder. Because just in the scriptures we read, all of those spirits is right there. I'm giving you revelation in the word of God. And that's how the spirit of jealousy stemmed up. That's how that spirit of murder right there tried to javelin David. Tried to kill him. Amen. So I just want you to know that we have to understand that these spirits takes us out of the will of God. It takes us out and we allow the devil to take over. And if we allow the devil to come in and take over, then we're not doing what God called us to do. What type of church are we running? And we got all these territorial, judgmental, jealousy spirits running around. The spirit of control and manipulation. All these spirits is birthed in the spirit of jealousy. Out of the spirit of jealousy. Amen. So therefore, we must continue to understand that we must not walk around with the spirit of jealousy. Just because your brother and sister have something nice doesn't mean that you have to be jealous or envy about it. If you ask them, they may just give it to you. I was at a restaurant and the lady that was serving me, she was like, "My God, your necklace is beautiful." All I could think about is the anointing. The glory of God that rests on me. And I looked at her and I said, "Lord, I know you can do something through this necklace because I know you operate through your elements. I don't know what this is, but she liked this necklace. I'm going to give it to her." And so I went to tell her, I said, "You know what?" I said, "I'm going to give you the necklace." She was like, "Oh, no." I was like, "No." I said, "I can get another one." So I gave her my necklace. She really couldn't believe it. But see, I knew that it was something else besides the necklace. I knew that God opened up a door for me to minister to her. Amen. And I believe that God even touched her through that necklace. Saved, delivered her, whatever her need was. I believe that because of the anointing that rests on me, glory to God, that was on that necklace, me giving her that necklace, glory to God, I know God did something in her life. Amen. Now, I ain't telling you to give away everything, but what you got to listen to the spirit of God. Let God lead you. Let God tell you and show you what to do. So she ain't had no reason to be jealous of me. All she said was she liked it, and I gave it to her. So why can't we compliment our brothers and sisters? Why can't we compliment one another? Why we got to walk around hating on one another? Why we got to walk around putting our mouth on men and women of God? Because you're looking on the outside. Don't you know they may be your next blessing? Don't you know that may be your breakthrough? Don't you know that may be somebody that God is using, but because you're looking on the outside and that you operating in the spirit of jealousy and you missing out on your blessing. They may be connected to your healing. They may be connected to your breakthrough. They may be connected to your financial blessing, glory to God, because you're allowing the spirit of jealousy to operate in you. And then the reason why most of the ministries are struggling, because you're looking on the outside on who God is sending in to help you. See, be careful, because you may be entertaining the angel. Glory to God. Glory to God. So I just thank God, because David, he was a man of honor. Amen. David understood his purpose. He knew that God provoked him into purpose. Amen. David knew that God had him in the right place at the right time. Amen. God taught David all things. He became a warrior king. Amen. His victories caused the kingdom to be established. Amen. Amen. David's struggles were with natural enemies. Behind these natural enemies were spiritual ones that was opposed to that kingdom, amen, that God have given to David, amen, amen. Because see, one thing we must understand is that this is a spiritual warfare. It's not against flesh and blood. David was fighting something beyond the natural, amen. But see, it was the Holy Spirit, amen, that was helping him, amen. Because even we know that the Holy Spirit contend with those powers of darkness, amen. Hallelujah. David began to pray some prophetic prayers. Amen. That had weapons with them. Amen. Because those weapons came against his enemies. Amen. Because see, the enemy tried to attempt to stop that promised seed that David had. Amen. David knew that he had a promised seed connected to him. Amen. See, David's victories and prayers opened the way for his throne to continue. And as you read through, we know the hell that David went through. But through it all, he succeeded. He succeeded, amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Because see, the throne of wickedness was unable to overcome the throne of righteousness. Amen. Let me say that again. Know this, that the throne of wickedness is not able to overcome the throne of righteousness. Amen. If we get into that place of prayer, if we get into that place, like 2 Chronicles 7:14 tell us, it will overthrow the throne of wickedness. Amen. So I don't want you to become discouraged in prayer. Know that prayer is your greatest, the most powerful weapon that you have. Amen. You got to continue to pray daily, because when you pray, you will become stronger and the enemy will become weaker. Amen. Because we all know in Psalms 18:37-40 that David consumed his enemies. Glory to God. He did not turn until they was destroyed. Amen. We must see our spiritual enemies completely destroyed. It's not against flesh and blood, but it's against principalities. Amen. Powers of darkness, spiritual wickedness in high places. Amen. We must not come down off the wall. We must continue to pray. We must continue to seek God's face. Glory to God. We must continue until we completely see our enemies destroyed. And we will never see that until the day that Jesus Christ come. Glory to God. We must pursue our enemy through prayer. Amen. Through prayer, through the word of God. Amen. And with our weaponry, which is the armor of God. Glory to God. See, when you pursue something, you follow in suit. You are to follow in order to overtake and capture. What we overtake and capture, we overtaking and capturing the enemy. Glory to God, in Jesus' name. Not in our own name, in Jesus' name. Glory to God. We must chase them down, glory to God. We must be hostile, hallelujah. We cannot be passive when it comes to warfare. We got to go in like never before. We got to understand the strategies, glory to God. We just can't go in letting our right, left hand knowing what our right hand is doing. We got to go in strategically, amen, to prayer, amen. We can't just go out and prematurely speak some things. We got to move in maturity, speak in maturity. See, David talked wisely. He said that he spoke wisely. He did things wisely. He went out and fought wisely. Amen. See, wisdom comes from God. Amen. Not your wisdom, man wisdom, woman wisdom, but God's wisdom. So you need to pray for the spirit of wisdom, not just wisdom. Glory to God. You need to pray for the spirit of wisdom. The spirit of wisdom. Glory to God. The spirit of knowledge. The spirit of understanding. The spirit of revelation. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You got to pray for the spirit, the Holy, so the Holy Spirit can come in and take over. Glory to God. And give you strategic strategies and tactics against the enemy. Glory to God. Amen. See, I thank God because David's victories prepared the way for Solomon. Amen. Solomon enjoyed peace and prosperity. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. See, we must allow God to lead us. Amen. 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 And right now in the name of Jesus, I thank God for loosening a level of peace in your life. Strategies, teaching your hands how to war. Amen. In the name of Jesus, giving you that place of prayer, that place of rest so that you can hear God. And I pray and I beg you, follow the instructions in 2 Chronicles 7:14. Because when we come together in unity as a whole, numbers is power. If we come together and obey the instructions that God has given us in 2 Chronicles 7:14, He will heal the land. We wouldn't have to do the things we're doing. Amen. Because the land would be healed. But these are the end times. It talks about it in Matthew 24. What's to come? So why are we surprised when it's already written? He say, just humble ourselves, pray, seek a space, turn from our wicked ways, and let Him do the rest. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. We give God the glory and the honor in the name of Jesus. And we thank the Lord for releasing His fire and thunder to burn up every works of darkness right now in the name of Jesus. We thank God for baptizing us again with a new refreshing of the Holy Ghost with fire in the name of Jesus. We thank God for allowing His fire to be in our hands to heal the sick, to cast out devils, to raise the dead in Jesus' name. We thank God that the fire of God will continue to burn in our eyes to see prophetically, burn in our hearts to turn to true repentance, to burn in our ability to stir up every gifting that He has given unto us, to burn in our mouths that the word of God can come out like fire in our feet so that our feet can get us to where we need to go, that souls will be saved. We thank God that His fire is on our tongue, that we will preach in the name of Jesus, His word in the name of Jesus. We thank God that His fire is released on our tongue, that our tongue has fire, that we everything that we speak, that yokes would be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. And we thank God for releasing the fire and the thunder of God to burn up every work of darkness now in the name of Jesus. We thank the Lord right now for allowing His glory to be upon us right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We thank God that He's releasing right now His thunder and even His arm with a flame of divine fire to scatter and every enemy in our life in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we thank God that the fire of God is burning up our flesh right now. In the name of Jesus, we thank God that the fire of God is our presence right in our presence right now, being released in our life right now. In the name of Jesus. And Lord, we thank you for allowing the fire of God to expose every demon, to expose every king and ruler of darkness right now in the name of Jesus. And we cast it out with the fire of God in the name of Jesus. We thank you for loosing right now your thunderbolts against the enemy now in the name of Jesus, to scatter the enemy now in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, oh God, that you continue, oh God, to allow our spirit, oh God, to be filled with your fire, oh God, in the name of Jesus. That every war will cease in our life, in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, oh God, right now, oh God. We thank you, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. We give you the glory. We give you the honor, oh God. We magnify your name on this morning. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. Oh, we thank you. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you, oh God. We thank you. We give you glory. We give you glory, oh God. We thank you right now in the name of Jesus, oh God. We thank you, oh God, that your angels are now, oh God, at work, oh God, in our life right now in the name of Jesus. We thank you, oh God, for loosing, oh God, unto your people, oh God, favor, oh God, divine favor, oh God, divine restoration, divine peace and grace and your mercy. We thank you for salvation hitting the land right now in the name of Jesus. We thank you that the fire, God, is hitting the land right now in the name of Jesus, oh God. We thank you right now, oh God. Oh God, we just give you the glory, oh God. We thank you, oh God, for replenishing in our storehouses, oh God. We thank you right now in the name of Jesus, oh God, for supplying, oh God, an abundant supply, oh God, and provision for our every need in the name of Jesus, oh God. We thank you in the name of Jesus, oh God, for giving us, oh God, absolute prosperity, oh God, and authority and dominion, oh God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you that miracle signs and wonders are following us in the name of Jesus. Oh Father, we thank you, oh God, you're the only one, oh God, who can abundantly, God, supply all of our needs, oh God, and we thank you right now, oh God, and we asking you, oh God, in faith right now in the name of Jesus, oh God, that you release this unto us right now, oh God. God, allow your angels, oh God, to go now, oh God, every four corners of the earth, oh God, northwest, southwest, northeast, southeast, oh God, in the name of Jesus, oh God, over all 50 states, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, to release, oh God, unto your people, oh God. We thank you, oh God, for your wisdom, divine wisdom, oh God. We thank you for your spirit of wisdom in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God. We give you the glory, oh God. We give you the honor, oh God. We just magnify your name on this morning, oh God. And right now, in the name of Jesus, oh God, I thank you right now, oh God, from loosing from us, oh God, every spirit of jealousy, oh God, every spirit of bitterness and wrath and hatred, in the mighty name of Jesus, out of our life, oh God, every spirit of confusion, oh God, and we command these curses to be broken off of our life in the name of Jesus. And right now, oh God, we command every demon to come out right now of jealousy, every demon of bitterness, of anger, of hatred, of insecurity, of rejection, displacement right now, of murder, in the mighty name of Jesus, of infirmity, of mental illness, in the name of Jesus, oh God. We take authority over all curses right now that's been placed on us, and right now, in the name of Jesus, we cast it out in the name of Jesus, and we command every spirit of divination, every spirit, familiar spirit, every deaf spirit right now to come out now in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God. And we thank you right now, oh God, for covering us in the blood of Jesus. We thank you for covering our minds, oh God. We thank you for covering our hearts, oh God, in the blood of Jesus. And God, we will continue, oh God, to glorify your name in the mighty name of Jesus. And Lord God, we seal these prayers right now, God, and every previous prayer, oh God, that have been prayed, and even those that will come on the fourth watch, oh God, prayers, oh God, that have concerned our lives, oh God, our families, our ministries, oh God, the country, oh God, our cities, our neighborhoods, our households, our marriages, oh God, our children, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. And we're walking right now in the timing of the Lord, and all the things are now becoming new in our life. And we even thank you, oh God, for healing us, oh God, from every affliction, oh God. And we thank you right now in the name of Jesus that we're walking as kingdom ambassadors, oh God, kings and priests, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. And we decree and we declare that it is done in Jesus' name. Amen. Glory to God. May God be the glory. And until next time, we thank you. Please join us on next Tuesday midnight for the Midnight Morning Glory. You can call in 857-232-0157, and the code is 716-052, or you can email us at midnightmorningglory@gmail.com. again, that's midnightmorningglory@gmail.com. may God bless you and keep you, and until next time, God bless you. We love you in Jesus' name. Amen and glory to